Hello. Today we're going to look at replacing your R11 and your Q6 on your Neptune control board. Obviously you've had the wax motor failure, and when that fails it causes Q6 to overheat, which shorts out internally, and then that causes the R11 to cook. Now I recommend you putting your board in some foil, just standard aluminum foil, if you're going to carry it from the washing machine to a bench, a kitchen table, wherever you're going to do your soldering, because if you walk across the carpet or some tile can generate static also, especially in the colder months when the weather is really dry. You can zap the board and do more damage, and you know, you have to buy a new board. So we have to take some static precautions to make sure we don't damage the board more than it already is. Okay, here we have the R11 and the Q6. The R11's, I've already changed these. I'm just doing this again for practice. And we'll go through the procedure. Okay, here we're going to clip the R11. Now mine, this is a good resistor. It's already been replaced. But on yours, you just clip the leads. It falls away. And when you clip the Q6, we'd like to have some leads left for our needle nose to pull. Okay, the R11, we will take and heat up the lead. Pull up. Once the lead gets to the temperature of the melting solder, you can just pull it up like that. Here we will try to do the same on the Q6. But our leads are kind of short, so what I'm going to do now is just push it down through, and then we will flip the board over and pull the leads out that way. Okay, here we have the R11 right here, and here we have the Q6, the three leads. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and pull the leads up. Sometimes I just take the leads and just squeeze up against the soldering iron tip. Once you know it's at the right temperature, then you can just pull the lead right out. Like that. Now we have to clear the holes out so we get the new part in. Okay, this is where our solder braid or solder wick comes in handy. You just put it on top like that. Once the solder comes up to temperature, it should clear that hole out, because the solder will be attracted to the copper braid. And go ahead and do the R11 also. And this board does have some track damage. Like that. Now the holes are cleared out. Okay, here I've turned the board over. Here's our R11. I've bent the leads to about half inch spacing. And here's the Q6. Now you gotta make sure you have the flat side that matches the silk screen on the board. You can't put this in backwards, but you can put this one in either way. The R11 doesn't care which way you put it back in. I'm gonna push them through the board, turn the board over, and we'll go from there. Okay, here I have the leads poked through. And I spread the R11 resistors out, the lead, so it will keep it in there so it don't fall out. And then we take our solder. Now when you're soldering, you gotta make sure you don't use too much heat. You should just put enough heat on it so the solder flows. Like that. These boards are low cost boards, that's why they tear up so easy. Copper tracks are pretty thin, plus you don't have, they're not double-sided, which helps make the part stay in better also. Okay, here we go. Go ahead and scrape some of the green stuff off the tracks here. That will expose the copper. I'm just using a little screwdriver. You can use X-Acto knife, whatever will scrape it. And then you just bend the resistor down like that. Then we will cut it, remove the lead, and you just take your solder, and this is how you repair the tracks if you use the copper wire piece you got in your kit also. And you just do that so it will just form into that one track, and then that will repair it. Okay, next we will cut the Q6 leads, be three of them, get those out of the way. Now we have to repair this track. Just make sure we have a good continuity. So I will cut this right just before I get to the lead for the triac, and I'll push it down. I've already scraped that track, by the way, from my previous repair. I was just practicing on this board. And then you just go like this. Gotta make sure you get the track hot enough too, along with the lead. That way it'll bond together with the solder. And there you have your repair. You can see the R11's here. We had to repair both tracks. We just folded it over, resoldered, and we folded this over and resoldered. And here's the Q6 three leads. Okay, here we have the new R11 and the new Q6 installed. Make sure you have the flat side matching the silk screen, as I mentioned before. You don't want to put this part in backwards. So when we take this board back to a machine, if we are at a table or a workbench, we'll go ahead and wrap the foil back up to protect it. Then we can carry it across to the machine and reinstall it and try it out.